Hello, friends! Crowns are often considered to be highly priced and incredibly valuable, even more so when they are hard-earned. The Miss America pageant crown and title have been coveted by countless young ladies over many generations. A queen giving her crown away is unheard of. But this woman is set to make history, just like she did so many years ago. Marilyn Van Derber stepped into the spotlight when she was crowned Miss America in 1958. But outside of that spotlight, her story started from a very dark place. She was born in Colorado on 6th of June in 1937. From the age of 5 to 18, she experienced trauma from her father's abuse. She was forced to endure this almost every night for 13 years. That traumatic experience did not come to public knowledge until she finally spoke up about it at the age of 53. Anyone else looking from the outside would have thought young Marilyn's family was perfect. Her father, Francis, was a millionaire, a powerful pillar of the community, and a well-known and respected Denver philanthropist. During the day, he served as president of the Denver Area Boy Scout Council and helped establish Denver's Cleo Wallace Village for handicapped children. At night, he terrorized his daughters. This was hidden from their mother under the guise of assisting his daughters to fall asleep by giving them a good back rub. Young and broken, Marilyn began to experience sleep deprivation because of her fear of being defenseless against the man who was supposed to protect her. Simply lying there until morning, she would watch the door all night, too terrified to move and unable to fall back asleep. She made a habit of locking herself in a fetal position while the hours stretched out before her, night after night. Yet for years, nothing changed. Even today, Marilyn says that falling asleep remains a challenge. As a result of the trauma of feeling so unsafe when she slept as a child, she never takes naps, and during the night, she either stays awake or uses sleep medication. To cope with the abuse, young Marilyn made a psychological decision to split her personality. Understanding that the night wasn't a safe time for her, she decided to maximize the day. This was when the version of her personality, which she calls the day child, was born. In an attempt to escape her dark reality and to dissociate from the trauma inflicted by her father, whom she loved, she pushed herself to excel, becoming a champion swimmer and a straight A student. It was her silent form of rebellion. As she has said, the more her night child was degraded, the more she pushed her day child to achieve. These accomplishments gave her a sense of having some control over her life, though she refused to be defined entirely by the abuse she experienced almost daily. The trauma showed in some different ways. Marilyn disliked playing with dolls. She also absolutely couldn't bear to be touched or hugged. When working as a volunteer with handicapped children, teenage Marilyn developed a special connection and empathy with the children she described as different. Soon, she was old enough to head off to college. This was when the abuse finally stopped. When she was a student at the University of Colorado, Marilyn was informed that she had been nominated as the Miss University of Colorado. At the time, she had no idea it was a pageant for Miss America. She believed she didn't have the talent to show off, and she had always been against the swimsuit competition. Eventually, Marilyn participated in the Miss University of Colorado show in 1957 and took first place. Taking it a step further, Marilyn competed in the Miss America competition and was crowned as Miss America in 1958 in front of millions who suddenly knew her name. Marilyn has described this experience as one that provides her with a springboard for everything she has done ever since. Why then would she choose to auction off her crown, which she has described as one of her most prized possessions? Stick around until the end of this intriguing story to find out. Following her win as Miss America, Marilyn learned that she was not the only one who had been abused by her father during all those years. Her oldest sister, Gwen, had also experienced the same trauma. After holding the title of Miss America for 1 year, Marilyn went back to college and received her bachelor's degree, graduating with honors from the University of Colorado. She was hired by AT&T to become the only spokeswoman for their television commercial and the host of the AT&T-sponsored Bell Telephone Hour. This show debuted on NBC in 1959. Aside from this, she hosted 10 episodes of Candid Camera and served for 5 years as a host for the Miss America pageant. Sadly, however skilled she might have been, she didn't stay long in these positions. From then, she decided to work for herself as a motivational speaker and guest lecturer for such companies as United Airlines and General Motors. In May of 1991, the story of Marilyn's private pain became very public when it appeared on the front page of the Denver Post, initially against her wishes. She later embraced the exposure as a way to create awareness about this issue, which is not spoken about very often. She has created and funded a program for survivors of abuse. In June 1991, she appeared on the cover of People, alongside the headline, Miss America's Triumph Over Shame. Marilyn has accrued numerous well-deserved accolades, such as Outstanding Woman Speaker in America, and recently, in 2011, the Lifetime Achievement Award. Of all her accomplishments, one that she values very highly is having been Miss America. Yet the crown and bracelet which were awarded to her as Miss America have been tucked away in a box in her closet for more than 6 decades. Her crown is adorned with Swarovski crystals, and its matching one-of-a-kind bracelet holds much value. The idea to sell her cherished crown occurred to her when she was interviewed for a documentary marking the 100th anniversary of the annual Miss America competition. Her crown is heavier than the others, very ornate and sturdy looking. All of this shows it to be very unique. This was when she decided to call Shoppies, a jeweler and trophy shop in Linwood. Shoppies has been in charge of fabricating all of the Miss America crowns from 1930 until 2004, before the pageant moved from Atlantic City to Las Vegas. From them, she learned that the crown and bracelet in her possession could probably sell for as much as $40,000. Deciding that these items were too valuable to sit in her closet, Marilyn Van Derber has offered them to be auctioned at Heritage Auctions, along with the trophy she received in 1957, and the sequined Alfred Boland gown she wore for the Miss America 75th anniversary pageant in 1995. The items will be auctioned between the 4th and 7th of November 2021, during the Hollywood and Entertainment Memorabilia Signature Auction. The bidding starts at $20,000. This is a historical sale, as it will mark the very first time a Miss America crown has ever been offered to the public. Why has she made this decision? Marilyn chose to offer her valuable jewels as a contribution to the noble effort to support teachers in Colorado, particularly in Denver, where she has lived all her life. This donation of the proceeds from her Miss America items would help support these teachers whose lives have been upended by the pandemic. This crown has tremendous value, not only in it being such a rare masterpiece, but also in the truth and beauty of the queen it belongs to. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up and tell us your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you for watching this video. Bye for now.